So happy to have Sam here. Are you still getting blasted on Twitter?
Say again?
Are you still getting blasted
on
Twitter?
Our 6 a.m.
Well, not blasted.
Yeah, yeah, like, right. It's not embraced. Bad. That's not a bad thing.
Right.
But yeah, no, there are people really like their show, which we're glad to hear.
And they like you. I'm getting all these people who are so excited that you're here.
Well, it's nice to be here. Dan, of course, will be back next weekend. And Lynette and I tonight on the Friends with Friends thing starting at 7 o'clock. I'm playing with my phone because I want to share a text in just a second with our very special guest. He's the menschiest guy of all time. There he is. Phil Rosenthal. Phil, can I read you a text that I got from your next door neighbor, Rob Penfold?
Sure.
Okay, here's Rob Penfold is like the Mike Wallace of Australia. He's a very prominent television reporter. Phil Rosenthal, my neighbor, best ever neighbor. He invites us all in to eat pizza and watch movies Sunday nights. He's such a great guy. My son and fiance were married on his and Monica's front lawn. We've got to get Phil to Australia for Somebody Feed Phil. But you know what? When you get an endorsement from the guy next door, there's nothing quite like that.
That's so nice. And that's before he's seen the bill for the wedding.
Phil, it's nice to have you here. There's a lot to talk about with the new season of Everybody Feed Phil. Before we do that, you're a very philanthropic person. You're a person who's been involved in the community for a long time. Do you have a thought, and it's a generic, about what's going on?
Yeah, we got to get through this, people. We got to get through, you know, the horrible virus that's a plague on us. And the worst plague is the systemic racism. And, you know, it's solvable, but we all have to work together, don't we?
I think we do. Some people would suggest that Hollywood has a part to play. And I don't know, what's your thought about just that phrase? And what should Hollywood be doing?
Well, we have to try to harder to be more inclusive. I try to do it through my show. I try to highlight as many diverse people as possible around the world and in America, because I think once you get to know people, you like them.
You make reference to a particular episode when you and I were talking a little bit before talking live on the air here. Somebody Feeds Phil, the basic premise, a big, big show on Netflix, by the way. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Around the world. You experience these different people and cultures through the language of food. We're going to look at a clip in a second from a remote part of the world. But before we do that, talk to me about this episode you shot in Chicago.
Oh, well, that it's one of my favorite ones we've ever done. First of all, Chicago is maybe the most handsome city in America architecturally. I was knocked out by just how glorious and magnificent the city is. And then the food, of course. It's a world city for food, and the people and the diversity. And I was welcomed in a black gospel church. It's one of my favorite scenes we've ever done, and just one of my favorite experiences of my whole life. It's funny that it should come out right now, but I think it has something to say to the times and to us trying to be together as human beings.
We're going to look at a clip now. This is not from Chicago, but that same welcoming environment. This Everybody Feeds Phil. Watch this.
I'm telling you, one of the most memorable meals of my life was to sit on the rooftop with this beautiful family who invited me after 10 minutes to come anytime I'd like to stay there, to eat with them.
The song is about you are welcome, you are welcome, you are welcome. Oh, that's the song.
Well, that's a very nice song.
In that clip, Phil, tell us what we just looked at.
You know, I could cry thinking about it. There are people who invite you to their homes. This was right outside of Marrakesh in Morocco. And they invite you to their homes. And, of course, you pay to visit with a Berber family in the Atlas Mountains, about an hour and a half outside of Marrakesh. But what you get is an experience, a cultural experience, and a life experience that you'll never forget. Look at their beautiful faces. Look at and they're so charming and wonderful. And you just get to know people at their house. And it's just a fantastic, fantastic thing. Here's what I'll say. Everywhere I go, I'm finding, this is a generalization, that most people are so much better than their governments.
That's interesting, because expand on that a little bit.
We have it here in America. Look at the trouble that we have with our own government, locally and nationally. But the people I meet, for the most part, are so much better. They're so much kinder. They want to give. They want to support each other. They are loving and caring people. Why doesn't the government reflect most people's hearts?
That's a very, very interesting remark. Let me ask you this. You are an investor and a supporter of a lot of restaurants here in Southern California.
Yes.
From that perch, from that perspective, how problematic has the pandemic been? I heard one analyst say, and this is going to sound very cold-hearted, that we were over-restauranted, that this perhaps knocks off the week.
Well, you know, that's a very cynical thing to say. You could say that about human beings, too, right? That's a terrible attitude. People are trying to make a living. So if we're over-restauranted, it's because people want restaurants and love restaurants, and the people who run them are trying to make a living. I've never invested in a restaurant to make money. It's kind of a stupid investment. But I support the arts. My wife and I have a foundation that supports arts in school, arts education. And to me, cooking, we've talked about this before, and running a restaurant is an art form. And I don't want to live in a world without restaurants. It's where I live my life. It's where my social life is. I don't think I'm speaking just for myself. But when we go to the local coffee shop and see our neighbors, or go to the diner and eat, and I would meet you at a restaurant, we'd have a meal. This is life. And if the restaurant industry doesn't get a specific bailout, because, you know, it's the second largest employer of people in the country after the United States government, right? We're talking about 11 million just restaurants, not counting the farmers, not counting the suppliers, the winemakers, cheesemakers. Now we're up to, like, if we count everybody who supplies a restaurant, we're talking about 20 million people in America. If we don't bail them out, the only restaurants left at the end of this will be fancy schmancy restaurants for guys on expense accounts and McDonald's and Wendy's and fast food, you know, the corporate fast food chains. So I don't know about you, Sam, but I don't want to live in that world. I want to go to mom and pop Italian places and Mexican places, Korean places, and all the things that make life worth living.
Quick question. Go ahead, Mark. He can hear you.
I have an uncle. He lives in Budapest. If he were to come to L.A.'s West Side, what restaurant would you recommend my uncle visit?
What restaurant would I recommend on the West Side?
Yeah, like near where you guys live.
Well, Phil's not a West Sider, I don't think.
I thought he's your neighbor.
But I can recommend.
No, he's not. Go ahead.
Okay, well, give me the West. Yeah, L.A.'s West Side.
I know places. There's Pizzana in Brentwood. This guy came from Naples and ran one of the best pizzeria in Naples, and now he's got two restaurants in L.A., and he's a friggin' genius. His name is Daniele Uditi, and he runs a place called Pizzana. I recommend that for everybody.
No, that Pizzana is absolutely fantastic. That's a very good recommendation. Pizzana. Phil, they're pushing us along. It's really good to talk to you. Thanks for joining us.
I love seeing you,
Thanks
Sam.
So much for all the stuff that you do. We'll tell folks, brand new season of Everybody Feed Phil has
somebody
just dropped.
Feed somebody Phil.
So, you know what? Why do we think everybody? Because of
everybody. Everybody loves rain.
Right.
So, I understand.
Yeah, well, there we
it's
go.
It's okay.
Somebody feed
as
Phil.
As long as you watch.
There it is. Somebody Feed Phil on Netflix now. Phil, good to see you. Happy Saturday to you.